first chapter, verses 1 through 5. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness covered the surface of the watery depths, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the surface of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and he called the darkness night. Evening came, and then morning, the first day. From the very beginning, O God, the majesty of your name has filled the whole of creation. From the very first day, O God, the light of your glory shines higher than the heavens. So, we have gathered here to praise you. We have gathered here to celebrate you. We have gathered here this afternoon in this house built by the life, blood, and love of your Son, Jesus Christ, to give you our highest honor and our most reverent worship. We have come to celebrate your creation of this missional move, this new community of faith here at Rogers Forge and Eden Korean United Methodist Church. Superintendent Koi Koi, Superintendent Kim, Bishop Shin, members of Rogers Forge and Eden Korean United Methodist Churches, former members of Rogers Forge, honored guests, staff, and families of Rogers Forge Children's Center. We gather here as one body, united in Christ Jesus our Lord, to write a brand new chapter on the pages within the hearts and minds of the people of this community, within the hearts and minds of our neighbors, the Rogers Forge Children's Center, and the families and children they faithfully work so hard to teach and to serve, and within the hearts and minds of the world beyond us. God has now called us together to this moment to respond faithfully and fully to Christ's great commission, to be in mission and in ministry with each other, each of you, and to the whole world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, let us celebrate. Let us humble our hearts to the presence, the power, and the purpose of what God is preparing to accomplish.
Come on. 영화이신 우리 여호와의 성전, 곧 우리 하나님의 성전 뜰에서 있는 너희여 여호와를 찬송하라. 내가 주를 위하여 거하실 성전을 건축하여 싸우니 주께서 영원히 계실 초소로소이다 하고, 문들아 너희 머리를 들지어다, 영원한 문들아 들릴지어다. 그러나 나의 하나님 여호와여, 주의 종의 기도와 간구를 돌아보시며 내가 곧 그들을 나의 성산으로 인도하며 그들의 번제와 희생을 나의 제단에서 기꺼이 받게 되리니, 오직 여호와는 그 성전에 계시니 온 땅은 그 앞에서 잠잠하시느라 주시라. 아멘. 자리 앉으시기 바랍니다. 김대미스. 시간에는 기독교 대한 답변에 멋있었지만 감사님이신 김영훈 목사님께서 우리를 대표해서 기도해 주시겠습니다.
거룩하신 하나님, 오늘 주의 백성들이 주의 몸된 성전에 모여 전심으로 예배를 드리오니 그 이름에 합당한 영광을 받으시옵소서. 주의 백성들이 주님의 은혜와 성령의 인도하심을 따라 희생과 헌신으로 이전을 보수하게 하시고 주님의 집으로 성결하게 하심을 감사드립니다.
Father God, today your people are gathered here to worship in your name. We pray that you may be glorified. We thank you for leading us according to your grace and your spirit, and for allowing us, through devotion and sacrifice, to occupy this space and make it holy.
오늘 입당하는 이 거룩한 성전에서 오직 신령과 진정으로 예배가 드려지게 하시며 주의 백성들이 평안과 기쁨을 얻게 하시고 이곳을 전하드는 모든 이들이 하늘의 복을 누리게 하옵소서. 이 성전에서 주의 말씀으로 구원의 기쁨을 누리게 하시며 이곳에 모일 때마다 주의 음성을 듣게 하시고 주님의 뜻에 순종하며 헌신할 수 있는 믿음을 더하여 주옵소서.
In this holy place, I pray that we can worship you wholeheartedly, that your people can find peace and joy, and that all those who come and go can receive your blessing. In this place, let us be able to pursue the joy of salvation through your word. Whenever we convene here, let us hear your voice speaking to us, and give us faith enough to devote ourselves to obeying your command.
전능하신 하나님, 그저 바라만 보아도 가슴이 벅차오르는 이 성전을 위해서 감동케 하시고 꿈꾸게 하시고 믿음으로 결단케 하신 것을 감사드립니다. 교회 이전과 입당을 위해 흘린 하늘 백성들의 눈물과 헌신, 희생을 기억해 주시고 주의 전을 세우는 일에 참여한 자들의 복을 세상에 증거하게 하옵소서. 이 성전이 기도와 감사와 찬양을 통해서 세상과 구별되기를 원합니다. 그대의 불씨가 꺼지지 않게 하시고 감사와 찬양의 노래가 흘러넘치게 하여 주옵소서. 이 성전에 모이는 자들이 주님의 이름을 사랑하는 것으로 세상을 넘어서게 하시고 험난한 세상에서 빛과 소금의 사명을 넉넉히 감당하도록 도와주시옵소서.
Almighty God, thank you for letting us be awed by this space, for letting us dream of our futures here, and through faith, choose this place for ourselves. I pray that you would remember all the tears and the sacrifice that your people have laid down in order to raise your new church. We pray that through prayer and thanks and worship, this place can be separated from the world. Let prayer and worship never cease, and let our songs of thanks be never ending. Allow the people gathered here to overcome the world with your love, and help us to become the light and salt of the earth.
오늘 우리가 호흡하는 이 세상, 참으로 많은 교회가 있지만 세상 모든 교회들이 반드시 자랑스럽지 않은 것은 이 땅의 많은 교회들이 하나님의 형상을 상실하고 있는 아픈 현실을 고백합니다. 그러나 에덴 교회는 교회의 첫 모습을 회복하게 하시어 하나님 보시기에 좋은 교회 되게 하여 주시옵소서. 방황하는 고단한 인생들이 이곳에서 쉼을 얻게 하시고 어디로 가야 할지 모르는 시대에 등불을 밝히는 교회 되게 하시며 이 땅의 현실을 부여잡고 눈물로 중보하는 교회 되게 하여 주시옵소서.
In the world that we're living in today, there are many churches, but we know that not all of them are righteous. We confess the truth that many of the churches on this earth have forgotten your vision. Let the Eden Church remember your original purpose, Lord, and become a church that pleases you. I pray that those with harsh lives and struggles can find rest in this place, and that this church can become a light unto the path of a generation that has lost its way. Lord God, let this become a church that acknowledges the realities of this earth and prayerfully intercedes in your name.
사랑의 하나님, 에덴교회 공동체를 든든히 세워 주시옵소서. 어린아이부터 노년에 이르기까지 주님의 사랑 안에서 하나 되게 하시고 주님 앞에서는 오직 그리스도의 성품만 나타나게 하여 주시옵소서. 다양함을 통해서는 풍부하게 하시고 하나됨을 통해서는 복된 열매를 맺게 하옵소서. 이 교회로 목자로 세워주신 신여성 목사님에게 성령 충만한 은혜를 내려주시오. 쉴 만한 물가로 인도하는 신실한 목자 되게 하시고 사랑과 공의의 말씀을 전하는 것을 통해서 강하고 담대한 지도자가 되게 하여 주시옵소서. 성도들의 마음을 헤아릴 수 있는 지혜와 그들의 삶과 공감하는 성품을 허락하여 주옵시고 영과 육을 감동케 하시어 주신 사명 감당하게 하여 주시옵소서.
God of love, we pray that you would build out the Eden Church on a strong foundation. From infants to elders, let them become one body in your love and act in a Christ-like manner towards one another. Let us become rich in diversity and fruitful in the singularity of becoming one body in Christ. I pray for spirit-filled blessings upon Pastor Shin, the leader that you've assigned to this church. Let him become a shepherd that leads his people by still waters, as well as a strong and determined leader who spreads the gospel of love and justice. Give him wisdom and empathy to know the hearts of his congregation and preserve his health in both body and spirit so that he may carry out his purpose.
하나님, 감사합니다. 또 감사합니다. 오늘의 감격과 찬양이 우리 모두의 삶에서 영원한 노래로 샘솟게 하여 주시옵소서. 이 예배가 에덴교회의 은혜와 축복을 세상에 증거하는 도약의 계기가 되게 하여 주시옵소서. 이 시간 주시는 하나님의 말씀이 우리에게 생명의 양식이 되게 하시고 두고두고 감동을 되새길 수 있는 그런 은혜의 말씀이 되도록 성령께서 역사하여 주시옵소서.
God, we give thanks to you again and again. Let the worship of this day become our eternal life song and rise within us always. Let this worship be just the beginning of the proof unto the world of your blessing upon this church. Let your word that we hear at this time become the foundation of our lives and let us remember it time and time again.
한없는 사랑으로 십자가를 지시고 마침내 부활하셔서 주님의 몸된 에덴 교회를 이루신 예수 그리스도의 이름으로 기도드렸습니다.
We pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ, who lovingly carried the cross, resurrected from the grave, and built the church that would become his body. Amen.
아멘.
Thank you. 믿다, 아예. 및 사무엘과 선지자들은 선지자들의 일을 말하려면 내게 시간이 부족하다. 그들은 믿음으로 나라들을 이기기도 하며 의를 행하기도 하며 약속을 받기도 하며 사자들의 입을 막기도 하며 불의 세력을 멸하기도 하며 칼날을 피하기도 하며 연약한 가운데서 강하게 되기도 하며 전쟁에 영감하게 되어 이방 사람들의 진을 물리치기도 하며 예단은 자기의 죽은 자들을 벌로 받아들이기도 하며 또 어떤 이들은 더 좋은 부하를 얻고자 하여 심히 고문을 받되 구차히 풀려나기를 원하지 아니하였으며 또 어떤 이들은 조롱과 책깃들 뿐 아니라 결박과 옥에 갇히는 시련도 받았으며 돌로 치는 것과 톱으로 치는 것과 시험과 칼로 죽임을 당하고 양과 염소의 가죽을 입고 유리하여 궁핍과 환난과 학대를 받았으니 이런 사람은 세상이 감당하지 못하느니라. 그들이 광야와 산과 동굴과 토굴에 의뢰하였습니다. 이 사람들은 다 믿음으로 말미암아 증거를 받았으니 약속된 것을 받지 못하였으니 이는 하나님이 우리를 위하여 더 좋은 곳을 예비하였으니 우리가 아니면 그들로 온전함을 이루지 못하게 하려 하십니다. 이러므로 우리에게 구름같이 둘러싼 허다한 증인들이 있으니 모든 무거운 것과 얽매이 쉬운 죄를 벗어버리고 인내로서 우리 앞에 당한 경주를 하며 믿음의 주요 또 온전하게 하시는 이인 예수를 바라보라. 그는 그 앞에 있는 기쁨을 위하여 식탁을 참으사 부끄러움을 개의치 아니하시더니 하나님 보좌 우편에 앉으셨느니라. 너희가 피곤하여 낙심하지 않기 위하여 죄인들이 이같이 자기에게 거역한 죄를 참으신 죄를 생각하라. 너희가 죄와 싸우되 아직 피 흘리기까지는 대항하지 아니하고 또 아들들에게 권하는 것과 같이 너희에게 권한 말씀도 이전보다 이렀으되 내 아들아 주의 경계하심을 경히 여기지 말며 죄에게 꾸지람을 받을 때 낙심하지 말라. 주께서 그 사랑하는 자를 징계하시고 그가 받아들이시는 아들마다 채찍질을 합니다 하였으니 너희가 참음은 징계를 받기 위함이 아니라 하나님이 아들과 같이 너희를 대우하시나니 어찌 아버지가 징계하지 않는 일이 있으리요. 징계는 다 받는 것이거늘 너희에게 없으면 사생자여 친아들이 아니니라. 또 우리 육신의 아버지가 우리를 징계하여도 공경하거든 하물며 우리 영의 아버지께서 더욱 걱정하며 살려하지 않겠느냐. 아멘.
여러분 저희가 드리는 예배에 많이 찾아와 주셔서 감사합니다. 자리가 조금 부족해서 좀 불편하게 앉으신 분들 계신 것 같아서 송구합니다. 다음번에는 더 넓은 자리를 준비할 수 있도록 네, 해보겠습니다. 이 시간에는 우리 볼티모어 워싱턴 연회 볼티모어 메트로폴리탄 지방 감사님이신 센티아 모로코이 감사님 나오셔서 우리에게 말씀 전해주시겠습니다.
굿 모닝, good afternoon. To Bishop Shin and DS Kim, to Pastor Shin and to Minister Meyer, 감사합니다. Thank you for the invitation to come and be here at this moment in history. My heart is full. My spirit is blessed. I praise God from whom all blessings flow that we are here today for this great, great celebration. Won't you bow with me in a moment of prayer? Almighty and most gracious God, we do thank you for this moment today. We thank you for the United Methodist Church and for its connection. We thank you for these two great congregations, Rogers Forge United Methodist Church and Eden Korean United Methodist Church. And we thank you, Lord, for their openness, to you and to the vision that you have for them together. We are just so grateful, Lord, to be a part of your movement, of what you are doing. And so now, Lord, we ask that you would honor our word that we have prepared, that you would bless it, so that it would become something more than just mere words on an iPad, but rather it would become your living, breathing word, your message for your people. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I do have to apologize because I gave Reverend Shin the wrong scripture. So thank you so much for what you read. But I would like to read from Genesis chapter 11. And we will start with the 27th verse of Genesis chapter 11 and read through chapter 12, verse 9. Genesis 11, 27 through chapter 12, verse 9. This is the account of Terah's family line. Terah became the father of Abram, Nahor, and Haran. And Haran became the father of Lot. While his father Terah was still alive, Haran died in Ur of the Chaldeans in the land of his birth. Abram and Nahor both married. The name of Abram's wife was Sarai, and the name of Nahor's wife was Milcah. She was the daughter of Haran, the father of both Milcah and Iscah. Now Sarai was childless because she was not able to conceive. Terah took his son Abram, his grandson Lot, son of Haran, and his daughter-in-law Sarai, the wife of his son Abram, and together they set out from Ur to the Chaldeans to go to Canaan. But when they came to Haran, they settled there. Terah lived 205 years, and he died in Haran. The Lord had said to Abram, "Go from this country, your people and your father's household, to the land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all peoples on earth will be blessed through you. So Abram went as the Lord had told him, and Lot went with him. Abram was 75 years old when he set out from Haran. He took his wife Sarai, his nephew Lot, all the possessions he had accumulated, and the people that he had acquired in Haran, and they set out for the land of Canaan, and they arrived there. Abram traveled through the land as far as the site of the great tree of Moreh in Shechem. At that time, the Canaanites were in the land. The Lord appeared to Abram and said, "To your offspring, I will give this land." So he built an altar there to the Lord who had appeared to him. From there he went toward the hills east of Bethel and pitched his tent, with Bethel on the west and Ai on the east. There he built an altar to the Lord and called on the name of the Lord. Then Abram set out and continued toward the Negev. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Reflecting on that text, I want to share with you this afternoon some words entitled, "Don't Settle for the Blessing, Lean In for the Promise." Don't settle for the blessing, lean in for the promise. Terah took his son Abram and his grandson Lot, son of Haran, and his daughter-in-law, Sarai, and his son Abram's wife. And they went out together for Ur of the Chaldeans to go into the land of Canaan. But when they came to Haran, they settled there. Terah was supposed to go to Canaan, the promised land. But on the way there, he stopped in Haran, and there he settled with his whole family. Because they decided to settle there, Haran must have been a place of great blessing. The land must have been very fertile. While there, Abram and Lot's livestock increased greatly. The land must have been full of valuable minerals and metals. While there, Abram acquired gems, silver, and gold. The land must have been very peaceful. While there, Abram and Lot's servants had many children and grew in number. Haran must have been a land of great blessing. But because Terah settled for the blessing of Haran, he missed out on the promise of Canaan. And if Abram and Sarah had settled for the blessing of Haran, they too would have missed out on the promise of Canaan. They would have missed out on a great promise. The promise was that God was going to make Abram and Sarai a great nation. The promise was that not only would God bless them, but God would bless others through them. The promise was that God would bless those who bless them and curse those who curse them. And in Abram and Sarai, all of the families of the world would be blessed. That was the promise. Oh, a blessing from God is good. Blessings provide for our personal needs and our personal desires. Blessings from God are good. But the promises of God are amazing. The promises of God are so much more than our personal needs and concerns. The promises of God are about ways in which God can use us to bless others and to change conditions and systems. Blessings are temporary circumstances, but promises are a permanent condition. So don't settle for the blessings. Lean in to the promise. Adam and Eve were blessed by the Garden of Eden, but the promise of God was that God would be with them wherever they lived. The blessing from God was that Noah and his family were saved from the flood, but the promise of God, which was sealed by the rainbow, was that God would never again destroy every living creature. The blessing from God was that Jesus walked this earth. But the promise of God is that the Holy Spirit is with us, and one day Jesus will come again. Don't settle for the blessing. Lean in to the promise. Sometimes when we are looking for a blessing and the blessings don't come, we miss out on the promise. The Hebrew people were just looking for blessings. They were looking for the blessing of bread and meat. And they forgot about the promise of a land flowing with milk and honey. And so they wandered in the wilderness 40 years until all of those who had grumbled about the blessings died out. They were not able to live into and see the promise. I am a planner. And this past summer, my husband and I went on vacation to Niagara Falls. As a planner, I had written a schedule for every day of our vacation. At my husband's request, a couple of the days I had simply written, "Do not schedule anything for this day." When we arrived in Niagara Falls on Sunday evening, I began to work my plan. I went online to order tickets for a Tuesday evening paddle canoe ride and dinner, and the tickets were sold out. There went Tuesday's plan. Monday morning, we were to go and play golf, and as soon as we got to the first hole, the heavens opened up and it began raining. There went Monday's plan. I had rescheduled the sold-out Tuesday evening paddle and canoe ride and dinner for Thursday. Late Thursday afternoon, the dinner was canceled because it was too windy to paddle to the island where the dinner was to be held. There went Thursday's plans. Friday, we went over to the American side of the falls for a quick run to the American bank, but decided to alter our plans and to stay and explore the American side of the falls. We took a trolley to tour the falls, and then the trolley broke down. We had to get off the trolley and walk up a long hill to the next trolley stop. Very few things went the way I had planned them. It would have been a blessing if we had been able to get the tickets for the Tuesday night canoe paddle ride. It would have been a blessing if we had been able to play more than one hole of golf. It would have been a blessing if the Thursday night canoe and paddle ride had not been canceled. It would have been a blessing if that trolley had not broken down. All of those things would have been a blessing. But if we had focused on any one of those blessings, we might have missed the promise of our vacation. Because in the midst of everything that went wrong on our vacation, we had one of the best vacations we have ever had. You see, the promise of a vacation is that you will relax and reconnect with who you are and who your loved ones are And in the process, we connect with who God is. And that week, in the midst of the wind and the rain and the broken down trolley, my husband and I connected. And as we stood in line at the trolley stop, we connected with another family, and there in Niagara Falls, we had conversation about God. Don't settle for the blessing, but lean into the promise. As a denomination, we have truly been blessed by God. But I sometimes fear that, like Tara, on the way to our promise, we have settled into our blessing. On the way to making disciples, we were blessed with many members, and we settled there. On the way to making disciples, we were blessed with huge cathedral-like buildings, and we settled there. On the way to making disciples, we were blessed with financial stability, and we settled there. On the way to making disciples, we were blessed with some influential and powerful members, including the Clintons and the Bushes, and we settled there. On the way to making disciples, we were blessed with some fantastic planners who through the years have crafted our book of discipline, and we settled there. Eden Korean and Rogers Forge United Methodist Churches, you have been blessed by this missional move. But I urge you, I beg of you, don't settle for this blessing, but lean into your promise.
Amen.
Most of you know DSJW Park. He speaks English very, very well. But every now and then, I will say something to him, and he'll get a strange look on his face. And then he'll ask me, what does that mean? The other day, while we were talking, I said, that is like the tail wagging the dog. He gave me that look, and he said, tail wagging the dog? What does that mean? It took me and another district superintendent a while to explain what it meant. Some phrases are just hard to translate. And leaning in might be one of those phrases that are hard to translate. So let me help. Leaning in means that you don't just settle for or become content with what is right in front of you. It means that you position yourself and work for something more. If before you start to run, you stand up straight, you won't go as far or as fast as you would if you were to lean in just before you start to run. So Eden Korean and Rogers Ford, don't just stand up straight and wait for things to happen. Wait for God to bless you in this new relationship, and then lean in and work toward and expect the promise. It is a blessing to have two very different congregations that speak two different languages sharing together in ministry. That is a blessing. But lean into the promise, just as they did on the day of Pentecost. Lean in until awe and wonder come upon this community because of the signs and wonders that will go forth from this place. Rogers Forge, it is a blessing that you were able to plan for the legacy of your congregation. But lean into the promise that through you, God has blessed Eden Korean United Methodist Church. Eden Korean. It is a blessing to have a parking lot. But lean in to the promise that every day that parking lot will be full of cars, because every day people will be coming to this place to participate in kingdom building mission and ministry. Don't settle for the blessing. Lean in to the promise. In the United Methodist Church, we believe that through each church, God has promised to transform the world. We believe that God will set this world on fire with the fire of the Holy Spirit. We believe that through the church, the world will be healed, made whole, and brought to right relationship with God. So yes, enjoy the blessing of this new relationship, but don't settle in this relationship. Lean in until through you, God has set this community on fire with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Lean in until the people of this community are healed and made whole. Lean in until this world is transformed. Lean in until God's promise is fulfilled through you.
Amen.
Amen.
We don't have Holy Communion. Precious. 함께 성찬 예식에 참여해 주시기 바랍니다.
Jesus gave himself up for us. He took bread. He gave thanks to you. And he broke the bread. And he gave it to his disciples and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you." When the supper was over, he took the cup and he gave thanks to you. Then he gave it to his disciples and he said, "Drink from this, all of you, for the forgiveness of your sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and in thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. And now let us pray with the confidence of the children of God.